Good morning. This is the special test series of the shoulder joint. So we are going to see special tests for the shoulder joint specifically for various conditions of the shoulder joint. So this slide shows the normal range of motion of the shoulder joint itself. So shoulder flexion is equal to 0 to 180 degree, that is 150 to 170, or extension is equal to 40 degrees. Shoulder abduction is going to be 180 degrees, and adduction is equal to 20 to 40 degrees. So it's also showing the abduction range. So on supine lying, how will be the adduction? 135 degrees. Then internal and external rotation on spine lying, showing shoulder forward flexion, showing. Then scapular elevation angle, it is also showing. So it is marked by the medial border of the. It's more marked by the medial border of the scapula and to the midline of the spine. So how much it is elevated? 45 to 50 degrees normal elevation. And inferior spine will be elevated while shoulder shrugging is 8 centimeters. Then internal and external rotation with at the shoulder level itself is 25 to 30 degrees. And external rotation at 25 to 30 degrees. Again the same. Okay. So next is the special test for the various problems we are going to see. I will list out the special test here. The test for the rotator cuff impingement are knee impingement test, Hawking-Kennedy test, MTCAN and the full can test, I missed it out, drop arm test, lift off test, and that is subscapular lift off test, and infraspinal test is spring back test, teres minor test, teres major test, apply scratch test. So for AC joint problem, we will see a painful arm sign, the forced adduction test in hanging arm, and Dugas test. For biceps tendon, we will see this three tests majorly. Speed's test, ergogenesis test, biceps tendon with transverse humeral ligament test. Okay. Test for shoulder instability is anterior apprehension test, posterior apprehension test, posterior derrier crest, and inferior instability and the sulcus sign of the shoulder joint. Okay.
So instability test, we are going to show many various instability tests for the shoulder joint. Shoulder main may be attributed to an unstable shoulder. Usually history of a period of intensive shoulder use, such as any competitive sports, can lead to this problem. And an episode of repeated minor trauma or overhead use or generalized ligament laxity, both young athletes and inactive persons are affected. Men and women are going to be same in this case. Okay. So we'll go to the further test. The first test we are going to see in this video is known as the anterior apprehension test. The patient will lie supine or sitting. The arm is abducted to 90 and laterally rotated slowly by the examiner. While performing the test, the expressions are noted for the apprehension, for further resistance to the rotation. Are noted for apprehension and further resistance to rotation. This is performed at 60 degree, 90 degree and 120 degrees of abduction to evaluate the superior and medial and inferior glenohumeral ligaments. With the guiding hand, the examiner presses the humeral head in the anterior and inferior direction. Okay, the shoulder pain is reflexive muscle tensing in the signs of anterior instability syndrome. This muscle tension is an attempt by the patient to prevent an imminent subluxation and dislocation of the humeral head. So this is called as anterior apprehension test, which is helps to find out whether there is an anterior instability of the shoulder joint. So next test, we are moving to the posterior apprehension test. Patient will be lying supine. So the patient is lying in the supine position or sitting position. Examiner flexes the shoulder forward to 90 degrees, elbow to 90 degrees, and stabilizing the scapula in one hand. The examiner applies the posterior force towards the shoulder joint itself, towards the ground, while lying in the supine, lying, and moves the arm in adduction and medial rotation. Applying force downwards towards the ground and adducts and medially rotates the arm. Okay, this is called as a posterior apprehension test for the posterior instability of the shoulder. Next, we are going to speak about the anterior and posterior drawer test of the shoulder joint. So the patient is seated and the examiner stands behind the patient to evaluate the right shoulder. So for example, in this case, we are taking the right shoulder. Examiner grasps the patient's shoulder with the left hand to stabilize the clavicle and the superior margin of the scapula while using the right hand to move the femoral head anteriorly and posteriorly, just like the anterior drawer test of the knee joint and the posterior drawer test of the knee joint. This also helps to step whether there is a, to find a posterior and anterior instability of the shoulder. So next is the inferior apprehension test or the Fegan's sign, as the words we say. The patient stands at the, with the arm abducted to 90 degrees and the elbows and shoulders resting on the tap on the top of the examiner's shoulders. The examiner clasps his hand around the patient's humerus and pushes the humerus down and forward. In the sulcus may also be seen above the coracoid process. So inferior instability of shoulder can also be found visible in this test. Then the sulcus test. The patient stands with the arm by the side of the shoulder and the shoulder muscle is relaxed. The examiner grasps the patient's forearm below the elbow and pulls the arm distally. The presence of sulcus identification inferior to the acromion is indicative. This is also known as the sulcus sign or the sulcus test of the shoulder joint. This also reports the instability of the shoulder joint. Similarly, we just pulling the shoulder downward direction. So keeping resting the opposite hand in the opposite shoulder and pulling the shoulder in the downward direction distally towards the ground. Okay, that is a simple test.